Your films are known for being original, and this story is no different. Can you tell us what inspired you, actually? Because it is unique.
I just wanted to sort of... I was quite into these sort of 60s and 70s exploitation films, and initially there was an idea of remaking a Jess Franco film, but then I just thought, why do a remake? And then I just sort of try to take some cool elements from that and see if we could just take it in a very different direction, perhaps maybe a more banal direction, a more domestic direction. That was the idea, really.
Was it interesting for you as well, exploring the whole kind of elements of control?
Yeah, it was fascinating. I mean, there's so much that can be done with that. I mean, we only scratched the surface, I think. But that whole thing relates to this whole masochism of this game, relates to acting as well and to directing. And I think that it's, in my mind, the film was also about performance and how tiring that can be, putting on another persona.
When you're writing for women as well, this is a female cast. How did you get into the female psyche to kind of understand her, how women think, to kind of write it, really?
I have no idea about the female. I have no idea about any psyche. I mean, I don't understand women. I don't understand men. That's why I write, because I don't understand people. It's my attempt to understand.
Is it an instinct?
I don't know. I mean, for me, it's... it's more curiosity, really. That's why I don't really do research. I'm not trying to do it out of arrogance. It's just these are fake, artificial worlds. It's not real life. It's absurd, but hopefully, within that bizarre world, you do see something that resonates. Probably not everything, but hopefully something.
For you as actresses reading this script, it must have been really very exciting, because it's quite unique, isn't it, the story?
Mm-hmm. Absolutely, yes. Incredibly unique. And what I was telling one of your colleagues, the thing that for me, for the script, was really clear and super inspiring was the fact that all the atmosphere, the tone, the temperature of the film were extremely clear. And yeah, so that's what I found really beautiful. I had like the images of were exactly what I found when we arrived on set, was exactly like that. So that I found it exciting. And I found it great because it stands out as something quite unique. As Sidse was saying before, the film is set in a time that is not specific, period, historical period or place. So that was very fantastic.
You're shooting as well in a real house, aren't you? So how does that help with regards to adding truth to your performance, really? Does it help you as opposed to being on a stage, to being in a house or a studio? Yeah.
Well, I think the sets on this film are just perfect. I think they've done a terrific work. I mean, all the, what do you say, aesthetics are really... up there, you can do that in studio as well. So not really.
And the whole idea of females and the role play, was that kind of exciting for you to kind of to tackle and try and look into the female psyche a little deeper?
Well, I was explained that it's just a world without men. So it's not, we're not lesbians as such. We're just these human beings. I'm a bit older than her, but it's not any stereotypical that kind or that kind. It's just two human beings in a relationship. And it's sort of to cut away any unnecessary messages, I think, more than creating a message. And what is very particular about his way of writing, Peter, is that there's some really recognizable, very precise dialogue, very, really, really good dialogue. And then there's, what do you say, it in the expression, you know, the limits are really out there. So visually and audibly, it's it's very original and new and artistic, and but there's still absolutely a connection to something that we can all recognize.